lessons, we learned three methods. First, which is a direct substitution. Next, which is the factorization. The third, which is the conversion between the infinity calculation to the infinitesimal calculations. So for this lesson, we'll revise for the fourth method, which is rationalization. So let me write it down. So for the rationalization, we have these four examples. So for the first example, so let me explain something about rationalization. Rationalization is only for the case that both direct substitution and factorization, and then even the conversion also cannot. Then we'll use the rationalization to check whether can or cannot. So for the first example, limit x approaches to infinity bracket square root x squared plus x plus 1 minus square root x squared minus x plus 1. Okay. And then the end of the bracket. Actually, did you know sometimes if you just look at it, you should know the answer straight away is 1. But how do you get the 1? So I'll work it out. So here, there's three types of rationalization, right? First type of rationalization, numerator rationalization. Second type of rationalization, denominator rationalization. And the third type of rationalization, which is both numerator and denominator rationalization, okay? So here, which one will it be? Numerator rationalization or denominator rationalization or both? So in this case, the denominator is 1. So of course, numerator rationalization. Sometimes we use numerator, sometimes we use denominator, even sometimes we use both. So let's see. For this part, since, did you know that this actually changed into the a square minus b square? What are you going to write in here? And here, you go. After that, there's a plus, which makes this part into because you're negative, and negative will change into a positive. And then denominator, usually you only rationalize if the denominator is an irrational number, right? But that's not always correct. most of the time correct because that we don't usually write a square root inside the denominator. We always say that the denominator cannot have the square root, which this part we when we write 1 over square root 2, square root 2 is an irrational number, so we could change it to square root 2 over 2, but this is not always true. Because they're here, pi is also an irrational number, right? No matter what, you still cannot take it out. If you like pi here, it will be a pi square. So it's still no use. The pi is always here. So, cannot. Okay, so now for the denominator, x squared plus x plus 1. So actually, if you want to combine, you can combine, but in this case, I combine except for in this case, I combine because the like this, okay. And then what about for the next step? What will we do? Should we calculate this part? Yes. So become 2x. And then what about the denominator? Do you know that we can use the math? So before that, just copy down the denominator first, okay? So did you notice that we can use the method that we used for last lesson, which is the conversion between the infinity calculation to the infinitesimal calculation? So in this case, we divide it by x. So here, it becomes 2. Then 2 over bracket square root 1 plus 1 over x plus 1 over x squared. Then after that plus square root 1 minus 1 over x plus 1 over x squared. Then like this. And then the differences here become 2 over 1 plus 1, and over here, infinity is 0 and 0, square root 1 still 1, same thing to this, and then 1 plus 1, 2, which, and then the answer becomes 1. But what if over here the question says that it's negative, only that for positive? So let's change it to a negative, okay? To see whether, how do we solve it? Most people know how to solve for positive, but what about for negative? There comes the problem, which is over here. So here, negative infinity. For negative infinity, where should we change? Where? I think this question is wrong. Oopsie. It's a negative infinity. This question is wrong. The answer is wrong. Why? Okay, let's see. Till this step, correct? So this step till this step also correct. But until this step, do you notice that your negative infinity divided by x, since here square, did you forget to take this out, the negative? So this part becomes negative 1 minus 1, which becomes negative 1. So this will actually be the actual answer for question 1. Since question 1 is about negative. So let me just tell you where comes the problem to most people. So because they're here, you might think that square already have no more negative, but didn't you realize that you need to take the negative out? And then it's something like here, 9 over negative 3. Then after that, so here square root. Then after that, you might think that like this, that the negative already no more, but the negative still have. It's just that at the 3 times 3, 9, which becomes like this, while this negative, you just take it out of the square root. Okay? So for the first question, don't get tricked. You might be correct until this step, but this step, you must note over here. Okay? The other day, if you're correct, then okay, then you got the answer. Okay, so here, if it say a positive, it's a 1. If you say a negative, it's a negative 1. Okay, so now for question 2, okay. Now for the second example. So limit, now then it's positive infinity. So, this which is x approaches to positive infinity, then after that, bracket, square root 3x squared plus 2x plus 4, then minus square root 3x squared plus x plus 5. Wait, so here, what indeterminable form is this? This indeterminable form is infinity minus infinity. So let me revise with you again. What are the 7 indeterminable forms? So the first, let me just read. So the first indeterminable form, which is, okay, infinity minus infinity. The other that, infinity over infinity. There's also the 0 over 0. There's also the 0 to the power of 0. There's also the 1 to the power of infinity. There's also the infinity to the power of 0. So we already have one. So what's the last one? Do you know what it is? So the last one, other than these, so here we already have infinity minus infinity, infinity over infinity, 0 over 0, 0 to the power of 0, 1 to the power of infinity, infinity to the power of 0, and 0 times infinity. Okay, like that. So here, this one. So let me tell you about something about this. So let me tell you that over here, this limit. So here, denominator, or both denominator or numerator rationalization. Which one is it? It's numerator rationalization. register a square minus b square, right? So for these cases, question 1 and 2, we mainly gonna use this part. So here, let's see. 3x squared plus 2x plus 4 minus 3x squared plus x. So the plus becomes a minus. Minus x, then minus 5, right? And then for the denominator, what happened? We just need this, which is a plus, right? And then the numerator, let me just calculate for a while. X minus 1. And did you notice this is another indeterminable form, which is infinity over infinity. So in this case, we already have two indeterminable forms, infinity minus infinity and infinity over infinity. Okay. So now, what about for the next step? For the next step, let's see first. So here, the conversion between the infinity calculation to the infinitesimal calculation. Okay? Then limit x approaches to infinity, numerator become 1 minus 1 over x. Alright, and then denominator becomes, so here 3, then plus 2 over x, then plus 4 over x squared. After that, plus 3 plus 1 over x plus 5 over x squared, like this. So the numerator will be 1, the denominator, but it's square root 3 plus square root 3. So let me first write it, which is 1 over 2 square root 3, right? So I think this could be the answer, but rationalize again, because that just now over Okay. So just get a quick look. Okay, I'm gonna erase it. So numerator, which is x squared minus 9 over square root x minus square root 3, right? So here, so let me just tell you, until now for the second question, we already used some methods, which is, of course, rationalization, that is our main focus. But we also got to use one more method, which is the conversion between the infinity calculation to the infinitesimal calculation, okay? So let's see for this question. Oh, it's not an indeterminable form, 0 over 0. So now we have make the third indeterminable form. Okay. So now, what we equals to? Did you notice something? The numerator you can use factorization. Did you notice? So let me just tell you why. Because that, since it's like this, did you notice it again? A squared minus B squared. But did you notice that denominator, now rationalization, is it numerator rationalization or is it denominator rationalization? It's the denominator rationalization. Okay. Denominator. So here, Now, we use this two times now in this question already. So here, x minus 3 times x plus 3, then still need to times the square root x plus square root 3, like this. And then, did you notice simplify? And then here, limit x approaches to 3. Then after that, x plus 3 times square root x plus 3. You see, I mean square root x plus square root 3. So here, which it will equal to, so sub it in 6 times, so 2 square root 3 with equal to 12 square root 3. We don't need to rationalize as in the denominator, right? So now, we already use 3 methods, which is, first, don't know what is it? You should know, of course, rationalization. Then the second method that we use, which is the earliest, the second earliest. Do you know what is it? Okay, so the second earliest, actually we use 4, not 3. Since, okay, so let me just tell you. The second earliest method that we used is the conversion between the infinity calculation to the infinitesimal calculation. Then the last two, of course, there's one which is the factorization. And Most importantly, there's one that we definitely got used. Direct substitution, right? Direct substitution. Okay. Factorization. So actually, this we already use all four methods that we learned already. So now, four method, the fourth question, okay? Perfectly proper. And then just, so let me write it down here, okay. So, fourth question, which is, limit x approaches, so over here, x approaches to 4, then after that, square root x squared minus 7 minus 3 over square root x squared plus 9 minus 5. Like this. This again is another 0 over 0. So until now we only met 3 in the indeterminable forms, which are all together here. Infinity minus infinity, infinity over infinity, and 0 over 0. So these are the three perfectly I wrote it together. So here. Then after that, this x approaches to 4. And then, what I rationalize? Denominator rationalize? Of course. Numerator rationalize? Of course. So which one is it? Denominator or numerator? No, it's none of that. It's both. What I mean is, you can't use any of the single method. That's why I say none. But I say both as we need both together. So that sounds quite funny. So here, a bit longer, we use this again. So all four questions, we need to use this a squared minus b squared. Okay, b squared minus b squared. So here, this part. If you notice that we go straight away, x squared minus 7 minus 9 bracket, then after that times this below with a plus, square root x squared plus 9 plus 5, and then the denominator, which is x squared plus 9 minus 25. Okay. And then here, square root x squared minus 7 plus 3. Simply simplify or not? So actually, is there anything to simplify yet? I don't think so. So let's go to the next step first. Calculation. Which here, x minus 16, and then the x squared squared. The x squared minus 16 again. Then this part, same. Plus 5. Then denominator, square root x squared minus 7, plus 3, right? So for this part, you know what? These two can simplify and then direct substitution, okay? So here, when we direct substitution, so 6, so for 16 plus 9. Let me calculate for both, yes? here 9, 25, and then become 5 plus 5 over 3 plus 3, which equals to 10 over 6. I'm done. Wait, not yet. Not done for the celebration yet. As here, we still need to simplify. Okay. We need to simplify at last until we cannot simplify. You don't straight away. So, okay. So for the first two questions, we both have these two, which is infinity minus infinity and infinity over infinity. And we use this one time only. And then, here for the first two questions, we used actually three types of methods. First type, rationalization, of course. Second type, which is the conversion between the infinity calculation and the infinitesimal calculation. And then the last type, they will use direct substitution in a 2 is 3. And then here for the third and fourth question, we'll also use 3. First, which is the, so the first which we use, of course, the rationalization. The second, which is factorization. In this case, we use just 2 times for both the question. And the last one, last but not least, which is direct substitution again. So let me tell you, we only have one of this indeterminable form, okay? So now we'll end here. Next time we'll continue with the video. And then if you like our video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Tune in for my end. Thank you for your watching.